quote, "It's a mammoth task, and it's almost impossible to convey with mere words the sheer scale of the mountain they have climbed, figuratively, and over the top of the island. But forget about the riding for a second. The logistics, planning and organization alone are an enormous nightmare. Then you have to build the bike, prepare for every eventuality, then transport your traveling circus to a small island in the middle of the Irish Sea. Teams start planning their next TT on the ferry home." And this explains how Norton is already working on TT 2015. Just days after packing TT 2014 back into the trucks, most teams in the paddock start with a basic setup and production bike. They know the road bikes work, so it becomes a matter of developing the changes needed to make it TT ready. The big teams will have setup data from previous years and will share data with short circuit teams, too. Norton doesn't have that luxury. There is no road bike to evolve into a racer for the Donington Hall-based firm. No race teams to compare notes with. And while it has data from 2013, the 2014 bike was almost all new. Cameron Donald is a vastly experienced road racer, but the first time he rode the bike at speed on the road was on the first lap of practice week at the TT. Most teams had already competed at the Northwest 200, worked on their gearing and stability, and found their base settings, but not Norton. If racing the TT is comparable to climbing Mount Everest, Norton is trying to ascend the Kong Chung face. Wearing flip-flops, practice is the key to the TT. You have to get laps under your belt. I know this from